such a long, long time. My sisters and I have missed you so. But hush now, my dear. Some new, some old, even some staff members themselves. Corvus, right over there. They're all asleep. Well, most of them. Some of them are playing a quiet game. Chess. But now, my friend, I just want we just want. asleep, but try not to fall asleep just yet. We have quite a few things in store for you, such as making you my, our new assistant. Giving you and decorating you your new mask, your very own mask, as well as some other things that I've acquired. During my absence. But before we go any further, I just need to do a little checkup. Margaret just needs to make sure that you're doing okay and there's nothing wrong, or at least nothing that Margaret and her garden cannot fix. So, my dearest friend, my dearest patient, my dearest seedling who has sprouted into such a magnificent specimen. Wow. Just wow. Have you been feeling lately? Other staff members been treating you during my absence? Oh, good, very good. Have you been having any strange dreams or visions? Anything out of the ordinary, that is? Okay. Is the most important part. And do you feel you've been getting enough nutrients from the soil? Very good. Over here. system. Which is now part plant, part human. Is functioning just fine. Would you do Margaret the honor of following this little pen light as it moves across your field of vision, okay? Just stare right here and follow as it moves across. Already know this. Just looking. Very good, very good. Well, my dearest friend, it was such a pleasure and an honor to be here with you, to see you, and I must say, based on what I can tell, you seem in good health. Let me just reach out here. Oh yes, very strong branches. Like your friend. must confess, I don't speak much Spanish, but I do speak Malayan. Tasa patasa takum fatana, kutu fatana, ralang, akunda santil, ungul migo, maskalo, nipata sa tongkondali, salatun, magastad, yanda. Enough about language and linguistics. I believe you've already met one of my other sisters. Now it's time for me to spend a little time with you. You're probably wondering what I've been up to all this time. Well, allow me to show you. I've been putting together my own little collection of seeds. Allow me to show you. I plan on selling these or making them available to all the patients or staff members here at Arkham Sanitarium, of course. First up, we have seem to be a little bit stubborn. As the name suggests, if you're looking to grow some eyeballs, well, all you need to do is plant some of these eye seeds, of course. Okay, my friend, and I will do the honors, or I would be so honored if you would be the recipient of these new experimental seeds of mine. You can plant them and let me know how they grow and turn out, okay? So here you go. Next packet of seeds. nothing seeds, made with nothing particles. As well. Put them right down here. Okay, next batch of seeds. Some teeth, spare teeth, teeth for a friend or a loved one. All you need to do is plant these seeds. And you can have those. Next batch of seeds. And these are quite interesting. These are Margaret's trifid seeds. I'm not sure if you know what a trifid is. It is a carnivorous plant that can walk around from a far-off distant world. So if you're looking to grow one of those, now you can. You can have that. Next. special. The exact nature and name of this type of seed or seeds has been redacted and expunged. There is no records of it, of them. So you will just need to plant them and observe what happens, okay? You can have those as well, my dearest friend. Just two more types of seed left. Such a bother. Anywho, these are Margaret's brain seeds. Obviously, if you're looking to grow some brains, simply plant and grow these seeds. I forget which species of brain, silly me, might be human, could be turtle, insect, I don't know, it's too late now, you'll just have to grow them, and see what types of brains grow out of the soil. And the last packet of seeds, my dear friend, and then it's time for me to go. So if you need a heart, or an extra one, or just want to grow a bunch of hearts, for who knows what purpose, then just plant these. Again, forget the type of species. Could be monkey hearts. Human xenomorph. Just have to find out for yourself next time. This is the first time I've done something like this. Next time I'll have to label the species on it. There you go, my friend. Enjoy. Now I must bid you farewell. It was a pleasure to see you again and spend this time with you, but I must go now and attend to the other patients and seedlings and sprouts. so good to see you. Since we last saw each other and spent time together, and I must apologize so sincerely. My intent was never to leave you for so long. My other sisters have already probably said, you are so magnificent. But allow me to share with you why I was gone for so long. This happens to be soil from the silent forest. Soil from a particular dark wood. You may be able to notice little white bits of nutrients, bones, teeth, etc., skull, femur, toe bones, hand bones. My secret little recipe, I've already mixed it in with the soil sample. So it's ready for planting. But I visited this place and I met an interesting individual. A talking wolf. The wolf man, I think. He said the soil is quite unique. I also bumped into a stranger who seemed lost, but if the whispering and talking trees are any indication, then this is definitely going to be quite soil. stretch soil from the planet of Norak Gol. I think that's how you pronounce it. Soil from another dimension. An anomaly. They kept me locked in a box for a while, although it was quite comfortable. There was a radioactive cat in that box as well. Sometimes it was there. Sometimes it wasn't. Eventually, I managed to escape and took this soil that was in the same room as me. Not this as well. Remember it from that myself on a quest to reforge a ring. And I did that, and I restored this broken kingdom, restored it, and then I kind of got bored, so I left. This was after I rekindled the first flame in Lordran. That was the main reason that I went away for so long, but one thing led to another, and I found myself on more and more adventures. You can have this. And the last sample of soil is from a planet on the rim of space, the very edge of space. For some reason, I and Chorus, the professor, and Dave and another patient found ourselves stranded on this planet with nothing but very primitive tools and clothes. It was quite interesting. Also somewhat sentient and sapient as well, so be careful how you treat it. Don't be surprised when it starts to talk to you telepathically, so you can have this. My final soil sample. Okay, my friend, it is time for me to go. Pleasure to see you again, and I hope that we get to see each other again soon, and not for such a large amount of time between visits. Sisters, had mentioned the plan we have in store for you. assistant. There are so many patients and seedlings and sprouts to take care of here in the garden, whether it's at night. Sisters tending to the garden, you would. All that warms our hearts so much to hear. Thank you. So, you were kind of expecting. You might say yes, so... Allow me to show you some of the tools that you'll need to use to do your work when you're not being experimented upon. In line. No, I'm just kidding. Well, the bad ones. So this will be used in some of your duties around the garden to dig up some of the patients, to make room for a new patient, and so on and so forth, okay? So you can have this. Oh my, you have quite a lot. Seeds and soil. Well, I'll put this here for you when you have more hands and branches for it. next door is this bearer. This pruner. You'll be needing to use this to prune the limbs, extra limbs that have been growing from some of the patients. In addition to any horns that need to be pruned, or tentacles, and of course, branches and vines, but mostly limbs. Sometimes the patients grow too many arms and legs. If you let them just go and don't take care of them, so you'll need to stay on top of that. You just prune an arm, prune a leg. Garden tool is this bone saw. Sometimes those limbs and tentacles, horns, etc., toenails get a little bit too tough. When you use this bone saw to just cut right through those extra limbs, arms, legs, horns, tentacles, etc. Maybe an extra head and neck is growing. So you just cut that right off, whatever it might be. Just remember, this is for garden use only. Please don't use it on anyone else in the sanitarium, okay? So here you go. And this is my personal bone saw that I'm allowing you to use, okay? There you go. Just grab that with one of your branches. Okay, my friend, it is time for me to go. It was so good to see you after such a long time. Hopefully, we'll see each other again soon. So what do you say? Just a minor adjustment. What a lovely sound. Okay. Let's get started drawing on your mask. Start with the lips. Won't do. What do you think about half red and half black at the top? Will be black and the bottom lip will be red, okay? So let's just paint that. Mask is all done and decorated. Well, it won't be complete in this session, but you'll have access to Margaret's colors and paints. Margaret will bury your mask so it is imbued with magical properties and such. It will become a sentient and sapient part of you. Okay, now for some black. Seeing each other again soon. my dear friend. Well, my dearest friend, my dearest, I don't know what to call you. You're no longer a sprout. You're no longer a little seedling that you once were. Well, it doesn't matter. At this point in juncture, in our little meeting, I want to help you to relax and sleep. You are now an apprentice of me and my sisters. And just look at my sisters giving you. You're so lucky. I wish I had some soil and seeds to plant. I wish I had a mask like yours. Unfortunately, well, fortunately, rather, I have my own biome. My own little ecosystem on my mask. An intelligent network that sees and feels and hears everything. But enough about me. I do love your mask so far. Red and black eyebrows, red and black lips. My sister sure knows how to paint and color and decorate her masks. Although she does get a lot of help from you, her patient, and other patients with their ideas. She thanks you from the bottom of, we thank you from the bottom of our hearts and roots. But now, it is time to sleep. Time to drift away to a dark but safe place. And to allow your mind and body to heal while it rests. Listen to the moss that grows from my mask. is what they call reindeer moss. The purple one. And then your more common moss. The green. But now it is time to sleep. Not to ever, 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 ever spend so much time away from you, my dearest, dearest friend. Just relax now. Silence.